to Top Tech Stories this week. And to all of you that just newly subscribed to our channel, we say thank you very much. We really appreciate you guys that have not subscribed. Please, what are you waiting for? Okay, I'll give you 20 seconds to quickly press the subscribe button. 19, 18, 17. All right, thank you very much, you guys. We love you, we love you, we love you.
Did you know that Africans have decided to own software development? There are a lot of software developers right now in Africa, and Africa is so saturated with software developers to the extent that Africa has started to ship out developers to the rest of the world. According to statistics from GitHub, that repository platform that we all know, the statistics have shown that developers from Africa have contributed a vast major number of open source softwares on GitHub. Companies like Andela are particularly known for this kind of model. Andela's model works like this. If you want to be a software developer, you register under a cycle. It's called a fellowship cycle. Once you register, you go through all the application process. Eventually, when you're successful, you get into the cycle. You are trained for a couple of months. And then I think there is like a four-year plan for you. And within that space of 4 years, when you are with Andela, you'll be paired with foreign companies. Companies in the US, in the UK, in Europe, or wherever there is a vacancy for software developers. And this model has been working for years now. And it has seen Andela produce a lot of senior software developers who are making waves in the tech industry today.
Big news for foreigners coming to China or already in China, because Alipay this week announced a feature that allows you to use Alipay right here in China and link it to your bank account over there in your country. How this works is that you can now top up funds to your Alipay international account with your international bank card. So if you are coming to China for the first time, or you are in China and you are yet to have the Chinese bank account, you can open an Alipay international account, download the app on iOS or on Android, and then verify your identity, then add your international bank card to Alipay. This allows you to directly convert money from your local currency directly to the CNY, which is the Chinese yuan. So the maximum you can add per time is 2000 yuan, and this is equivalent to about $300. One more thing about this is that this service is limited to just 3 months. So it's expected that before 3 months you are able to finish your transactions in China. If you are just passing by, or you are a tourist, or you are a student, you are able to now get your visa and open your bank account in China. One immediate use of this service is for foreigners who just arrived China and want to take a taxi or want to use a restaurant, and then they don't have access to the local currency, the Chinese local currency. So you can quickly use this service to top up your Alipay international account and have funds available immediately to you from your local bank account. So why don't you try this service and let us know what you think about it. Please share this so that your friends who are outside China planning to come into China very soon would know how easy it is to make payments in China via this new feature enabled by Alipay. Hopefully we are going to see services like WeChat enable this as well.
In the other news, Google introduces an app defense alliance that helps to curb malicious apps from entering into the Google Play Store. So what they did was to form a partnership with antivirus companies to ensure that any app that is uploaded to the Play Store is not malicious. While we are still celebrating 5G being launched last week, precisely November 1, by three of China's biggest mobile telecom providers, China has started research on 6G. And finally, great news this week coming from Sudan. Sudan just launched a satellite in partnership with China. This is Sudan's first and ever satellite launched into space. The partnership with China, they hope that they can use this satellite to gather data and also for research purposes.
That concludes Top Tech Stories for this week. I hope you enjoy the stories, and please don't forget to go to our YouTube channel, youtube.com/techvangelist, and subscribe. See you next week.